There is a machine quilting stitch I have got to show you on the Bernina 570 Quilters Edition. Now, since this machine is designed for quilters, there is some extra stitches in the quilting menu that most people don't realize what they are. And the one we're actually talking about is stitch number 1301. Now, we do talk about sewing out your decorative stitches, sewing out all these different styles, because there's so many similar ones. What makes one different than the next? And on screen, it's sometimes hard to tell. When I touch the question mark and I touch stitch 1301, it's called the Quilter Securing Program. So I do use this when I'm actually doing kind of stitch in the ditch or stitching quilting style straight line through batting. So I'm actually needing to secure the stitches at the beginning and secure them at the end. But I want to do back stitches and I don't want it all in the same hole, because all the stitches in the same hole, that kind of builds up a little knot on the back and then I've got this rough spot. So let me show you how to use this stitch and what and where is the best place to use it. So we've been working through some of the other stitches in the quilting menu, and also one of my favorite stitches. This is my own manipulated stitch. It's actually one of the stretch stitches, by the way. Blanket stitches, applique stitches, satin stitches. But this stitch is a little bit more utility. So I am gonna stitch it on white fabric. I am not doing it through batting, only because I wanna be able to really show you up close what it's going to do. And I have some variegated thread in the machine. So I'm going to stitch very slow because the first couple stitches are to be little tiny, 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 and then they get big. So this would be like where you want to start, maybe at the edge of your quilting, maybe you're quilting where your blocks are intersecting, and you need it to lock where you're starting. So as you stitch, you're also going to notice on screen you've got a reverse button blinking. So when I'm ready, I'm going to be touching this button as I get to the maybe place where I want it to stop. As I push it, I need to allow for a little extra distance, so I push it before I need it, and because it's going to sew those six little stitches, tiny, tiny, and then it stops. So that actually is stopping for me. I didn't stop sewing, it kind of did it for me. But let's take a look. Right here, I don't have to worry about those stitches coming out. And same for up here, I can cut that very, very close, and those stitches are perfectly held. I can also trim them really close on the back side. So where that little tiny guy back here is been pulled to the back and cut, I can come back there and trim that really, really close. I want you to try that next time you're doing some straight line quilting, some echo quilting, some grid quilting, and see if that makes a difference. Trust me, when you need to stop and start so many times, that is the stitch you want to pick. Let the machine do the work for you, and you can just enjoy the quilting process.